your best leads. I see. Quickly view how.
Is Zoho marketing automation confusing the hell out of you? Well, you're not alone. There's a ton of people out there who feel the same way. So make sure you tune into these tutorials to make sure that you get your system set up properly at the start. In today's tutorial, we're going to talk about lead scoring and how you can go about setting it up to make sure that you are getting the proper leads in your system. So let's log in and I'll see you there.
All right, now that we're logged in, we're going to go to our lead scoring and we're going to set it up. So if we go over here under qualification on the left-hand side, you can see this lead scoring tab. We want to click that. And now we can start assigning scores and setting it up. So every action of a lead counts, and that's very true. Once you see it, you're gonna be overwhelmed. So we're gonna start assigning scores. So we can set up a unique open as a certain score. We can set a multiple open, so that's if they open it multiple times, as another score. We can set a unique click to be a certain score, a multiple click to be another score, unique reply, multiple reply, positive reply, an opt-in, and a tell a friend. So this is set up to mainly help gauge how interested your leads are and what kind of interaction they are having with your content. So for example, if they only open once and that's it, you never see them again, they never open any of your email, they'd only get 10 points. But if they opened your email once and then they opened it two more times and then they clicked on a link, well, that's gonna be 10 plus 20 plus 20 plus another 20 for a unique click. So you can see right there, it starts to add up, and this score is very dependent on you. You can set it to be whatever you want. We can only set it to be up to 99 is the max. And this gives you a really good understanding of how interested your leads are in working with you. So throughout all of this, we have these options. And if we just click save right now, these are the general options that are chosen. Zoho has put these in for us. We can always go back in and edit this if we need. So let's just save it for now. And so as you can see, we have these options under the campaign activities. We can also do field-based scoring. So if we click on this, we can set up scoring based on different fields. So if they have a certain criteria you like more so in one lead versus another lead, you can set that up. So if their job title was, say, an engineer, well, we can set this up as it's going to add in 50 points because you know that engineers are your target job title. So we could go ahead and create that. So let's say engineer job title, just put that in. And now we've created a field-based scoring based off of that job title field that we just created. So there's ways to go about that. Now below, we also have a web assistant based scoring, and we haven't set up any of our web assistant yet because we haven't gotten to that point. So we're not going to dive into detail on this one yet. Just know that you can set up web assistant based scoring based off of your web domain. So depending on how they're interacting with your domain, you can actually set up some scores as well. So for the last thing here, we have the lead classification. So let's go ahead and set that up. So right now we're given an overview of hot leads, warm leads, cold leads, and scores in the last 15 days. So we have a couple different options here. Now what this is actually trying to say is if your lead is greater than, let's say, 50 points, then it is considered a hot lead and will be classified as such. So we can search on hot leads because we know that they are interacting with our content more than any others. Now, if we have a warm lead, we could say 25 points to 50 points is going to equal a warm lead for us. Now, a cold lead won't meet any of that criteria, so it is not going to be included, but every other lead is going to be classified as a cold lead. However, we can also set up the score in the last 15 days, last month, last 3 months, last year, whatever it is. We can set it up so that the hot leads are greater than 105 over the last 15 days, or the warm leads are greater than 50 to 105 for the last 15 days. So now this is integrating a time component as well. So it allows you to get pretty granular with your leads so that you know you're only looking at the most active of your prospects. So this is a great way to go about setting up lead scoring so you know which leads you should be focusing on. Now that's pretty much it for this one. We'll talk about the web assistant based scoring in a future video. And just to review the scores over here, we haven't created any views, but this is where you'd go about creating your hot leads, your cold leads. You can create different views. So we want to know when a score is equal to, greater than, not equal to, less than, between. So we're just going to say we want to know when a score is greater than 100. We want to know in this list over all time that we've had these leads in the system. And we can even add in different lead criteria, and we can select specific mailing lists or all mailing lists. And for this, we're just going to say greater than 100. So this is going to show all leads that meet this view. And obviously right now we don't have any leads in our system, so this isn't going to show up with anything. Now this is a great way to monitor and see what leads, which prospects of yours are the most important to be focused on, and monitor them as well as set them up. So we hope this video has been helpful. Make sure you subscribe to our channel below. As always, we want to make sure that everyone who is running into these issues gets this content as soon as possible. And by you subscribing to our channel and connecting with us in the comments or liking our videos, that helps us reach more people. So please, please, please make sure that you are following us and commenting and liking our videos. And as always, feel free to join us on our other community channels like Facebook and Instagram, and we look forward to seeing you there. Bye for now.